Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much for being here on this really exciting day. It is so exciting to be welcoming back commercial passenger air service to the Salem Airport. And this day, I wasn't always sure we were going to get to this day, but here we are. And it's for many of us, it's a big sigh of relief today. The vision of Salem having passenger air service has been a shared one with so many of our community members, our partner organizations, elected leaders, and business owners working together toward a common goal of moving our city forward. In the last decade, our city has grown dramatically, and more growth is on the horizon. It's expected that in another 10 years, our valley could add 100,000 people. As the mayor of Salem, it's my responsibility to plan for that growth, while also honoring our culture and our identity. Every day I ask myself, what is the best thing for the city? How do I build an economy to provide jobs? How do I get more homes, decrease homelessness, and stop crime? Since joining the Salem City Council in 2017, it's been my honor to be one of the volunteers responsible for coming up with those answers, along with these fine individuals right next to me, members of the Salem City Council. On any given day, especially this week, it's no easy task. And I've seen earnest and resolute activists becoming disheartened by the difficulty of crafting effective public policy and at a pace at which solutions can be implemented. Sometimes we don't get it just right. Sometimes the timing just isn't right and the project fails. But in Salem, we get back up on that horse and give it another go. Just like today, here we are. Since 1853, our city has been home to the state capitol and the responsibility of hosting a great debate on how to realize the American dream. The result of anchoring that debate has created a culture of people who believe in public service and civic responsibility, a people who believe in equity and inclusiveness, of creating affordable homes and safe streets, and of fostering innovation and job creation. Through Salem Hospital, we are home to some of the best doctors and healthcare professionals who work at the busiest emergency room on the West Coast. With over 40,000 students, we are home to the second largest school district in the state. And now, as one of Time Magazine's world's greatest places, the city of Salem is home to a commercial passenger airport. The residents of Salem make our community thrive, but small businesses and entrepreneurs are vital to the success of every city. I believe this airport will enable further investment in the region and will bring economic growth that will play an important part in matching the population growth that is expected in the Willamette Valley. Thank you so much for being here to join us today. It is now my great pleasure to introduce Courtney Goff from what I like to call Redacted Airlines. We've been referring to it as Redacted Airline for so many months that I'm not going to say the name. I'm going to allow her to do that. So, Courtney.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. And so now I guess we can officially say we are not the Redacted Airline, and we can say hello to Avelo. Hello. I am with, oh, thank you. I guess somebody got my memo this morning to follow me. We're so excited to start service at the Salem Airport, and I think what everybody wants to know is where we're going to fly. We're going to fly to two nonstop routes from Salem. We're going to go to Southern California via Hollywood Burbank, the most convenient airport in the Southern California LA Basin, and we're also going to go nonstop to Las Vegas, to Harry Reid. Those routes are going to start, Vegas is going to start on October 5th, and it's going to operate on Thursdays and Sundays. Burbank is going to start on the 6th, the next day, and it's going to be on Mondays and Fridays. But once we get a little bit into the season and closer to football season, we're going to switch it over to that Thursday, Sunday, so everyone can have a little bit longer of a weekend there. And great, great next thing is the prices are going to start as low as $39 one way. So for less than $100, you can go enjoy a weekend in Vegas or go catch up to the beaches in Southern California. Just a little bit about Avelo for those that might not know. We started service in April of 2021, so we're just over 2 years old. But in those 2 years, we've already flown over 2.5 million customers on over 20,000 flights. So while we're new to Salem, we're not new to flying. As some of you may know, we do fly down to the southern part of the Willamette Valley in Eugene. So we're excited that, like the mayor said, with all the growth coming here and with everyone transitioning from the north and the south and east and west to the Salem greater region, we're going to be able to offer some commercial air service where we haven't had it in nearly 15 years. We have 5 bases across the country in Hollywood, Burbank, in New Haven, Connecticut, Wilmington, Delaware, Raleigh-Durham, North Carolina, and in Orlando, and we're about to open our Vegas base in September, which will enable this flight to Vegas. We have over 900 employees, which we call our crew members. So everyone's a crew member, from myself to the pilot to the person that does accounting. And we have 16 planes in our fleet. So we're continuing growing. We're expected to have about 4 to 6 more by the end of Q1 of 2024. So always continued growth and always making sure that we're flying places that our customers want to go to. We know that everyone has their favorite routes, but we want to make sure that we're catering to the general public on that sense. We hope to inspire travel. That's our mission. Why we started flying is to inspire travel. And we do that with really low fares, really convenient airports, and of course the reliability factor. All through Q1 and even part of Q2 of this year, we were leading in reliability with the most completed flights and the least cancellations in the industry among all carriers. So we're really excited about that, to bring that to this area. Tickets are on sale right now. Something fun I was talking to someone earlier about is we've catered to where, if you go on our website, for those that are used to flying out of Eugene, if you type in Eugene, Salem's going to pop up too. So that way those that might be used to going south to Eugene will now realize we're here in Salem and they can fly out of their own hometown airport. So thank you guys so much for everything. And hello, Avelo. I'm going to drop this. I guess I should have done this earlier, but let's try to fold down. There we go. Hello, Avelo. And once again, thank you guys so much for being here. I know that myself and some other people will be around to answer any questions, and I'll throw it back to the mayor now so he can give you a little more scoop. And I'll answer questions after, if that's okay.
Thank you so much, Courtney. Isn't this amazing? We're going to Vegas, baby. We're going to Vegas. And I couldn't be more excited.
Already booked.
Is that right? Nice. I hope that I was intending to book a flight before this, but I've been running today, so I haven't had a chance. I hope it doesn't sell out before I get a chance to book on that first flight. Well, you know, this didn't happen today just through the efforts of the city alone. This has been a great community partnership, whether it's our friends at the Chamber of Commerce or Travel Salem or Fly Salem. I mean, everybody came together to make this day happen. I want to just do a quick list, a quick shout out to a bunch of folks who really made today possible. Like I said, Travel Salem, Fly Salem, Salem Area Chamber of Commerce, Marion County, the TSA, including Kathleen McDonald, Federal Security Director for Oregon. And I believe Kathleen is here. Welcome, and thank you so much for your great partnership and making this federalization of our airport happen. We really appreciate it. Also, our partners at the FAA. And really, I want to give a shout out to the City of Salem staff. It was really the leadership of our city manager, Keith Staley, who really made this project come together and actually come to reality today. Also, our airport manager, John Pascal. I know you're here. Clear in the back, John Pascal. But then the project team, including Jim Bonnet, who came out of retirement to make this happen, Kirk Sund, the project lead from CB2, Tyler Anderson, the project lead from Cedar Mill, Alan Rasmussen from Modern Building Systems, Mark Bechtel, our Public Works Operations, and Alan Dannon, our city engineer. Can we give them all a round of applause? And now it is my great honor to introduce my friend Angie Villery from Travel Salem.
Well, good morning. I'm a little emotional today. You know, I don't get emotional all the time, right? I mean, I'm not a very emotional person. Very passionate about what I do. Tourism is the lifeblood of this community. And it has been truly an honor to work on this project. Been working at it now for 5.5 years to move toward today. And it did not happen without a valiant effort from some of our local stewards. I'd like to thank Brent DeHart, who has been the engine and the heart behind this, and my partner in crime with all the work that we've done. Tom Hoffert with the Chamber has been extraordinary, and your entire team, and all of our partners at Fly Salem. This has been something that we knew this community needed, and we know what it means for this community long term. I've said before that this is like putting a Fortune 500 company right in the middle of the community. The job creation and just the exponential ripple effect of bringing in new dollars to our local businesses. So on behalf of the entire tourism industry, we're so excited. We have conferences and groups that want to come here, and they're on our waiting list. They said, as soon as you have commercial air service, let us know, and we'll be there. So we have a lot of work to do, and we're very excited about that. And I want to thank the mayor for his incredible leadership. And it takes a lot of courage to do certain things that are outside the box, that cost money, that demand, you know, resources. And his partnership with our new city manager, Keith Staley, has been amazing. And the two of them really are to be thanked in our entire city council. So I want to thank all of you for being here today, and we can't wait to fly to Vegas. So thank you.
Thank you, Angie. And now it is my honor to introduce Tom Hofford, the Executive Director of the Salem Chamber of Commerce.
Well, this is a very special day, and this community deserves days like this. There have been incredible thanks, but I need to echo a few, and this was an incredible undertaking, not just by the public sector and the incredible work our city staff did, and by the way, it was a great honor to partner with the mayor, the council, to work with Keith Staley's staff and see how we can make things come together for real positive results. And credit to Jim and so many of the staff members to make this happen. But it was also the vision of those people in this community that see bigger things. We know the trajectory this community is on. And one of the things that the mayor and I shared in conversation is you invest in places that are important to you. This community matters. Salem matters. People want to come not just to live here, but to visit this great Willamette Valley. We get to show off the incredible wineries we have, the incredible arts and culture, our rivers and streams, our natural elements. We become a destination for people to choose to come to see Salem. That's powerful. It helps our small business community. It helps keep employment. And it helps the engine keep running, not just for Salem, but for the entire Willamette Valley. It is about conductivity, allowing people to come in and out, but still call Salem home. This was a brave act by our city council, and I applaud them for this. This was a brave act by our citizens and residents of Salem to say, we'd like to avoid driving up and down I-5 and pull in right into this parking lot, right, Keith? Right out there. We're going to pull in and be able to access different parts of our nation. And Courtney, someday we hope different parts of our world right out of this hub here in Salem. So a hearty thank you to the small business community for believing that this could happen. And today is day one. Now the work begins. We need to fill these flights because we have a bigger vision. At the Salem Chamber, we believe in helping businesses prosper so our entire community may thrive. And that means, with all due respect to Avelo, we hope there are additional airlines going down this aisle that you get to choose from in the years to come. Salem, we applaud you. Thank you all for the support today. We appreciate our board of directors who stood firmly behind this. Thank you to Angie and the team and the board team at Travel Salem, and to the city council and the city team, staff professional team, for making today a reality. Let's celebrate this moment. Thank you, Salem.
Thank you all so much for being here. I encourage you to step over to this area I encourage you to step over to this area and enjoy some refreshments. Also, outside onto the tarmac where you can see our ground equipment. Some of the new equipment that's out there is courtesy of a grant from the state legislature that was purchased. Raquel Moore Green, when she was a state representative, earmarked her ARPA dollar allocation to help us purchase that ground equipment. So I encourage you to get outside and take a look at the ramps, I can't think of all the names for them, the things that make this all work. So also we have a couple of our ARF trucks out there. That's the, I believe, air response vehicle, firefighting vehicles that are out there, our fire trucks that are required. So I encourage you to get outside and take a look at some of those things. So thanks again for coming, everybody.
you my card in case you...
Yep. I'm here, but I'm...